we have. I need something that's going to get people talking now.
I might have something. I've been investigating a story about young women being recruited by extremists over social media.
This is brilliant.
How do you make contact?
I created a fake profile, posing as a young convert to lure one of the recruiters to me.
I'm going to share my screen.
It's kind of hot.
Do you think?
The IT guys can record your desktop.
Mamie, tattoos are prohibited.
Can you see the tattoo?
No. Ready to go.
He's calling.
And I'm going to record it all.
Assalamu alaikum, my sister.
Hi, I'm Kit. So nice to meet you. I'm with ScreenPicks. This was fantastic. I'm actually a big fan of these movies. You know, I loved Unfriended and I did love Searching. I mean, it's so fascinating to watch. I mean, I kind of read a little bit about how you had to like manipulate everything on your screen. Was that difficult to do?
I think at the beginning, it was, because I wasn't like that super tech savvy, but and actually in the rehearsal, I sat down with the producer who is very tech savvy and sort of went through just as fast as we needed to, because it's a movie, so it needs right. to be dynamic and interesting. And, you know, we were able to do certain things in post, but because we were recording my screen, I really had to do it in real time. So that was difficult and tricky, but it was interesting to learn a new language. It was like learning a new language, you know?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. And the one thing that it's like, you know, I'm on the computer all the time too, but I just don't know. I mean, to be able to, you know, go through all
that. The actual laptop was attached to a rig. So with like microphones on it and another camera and lights. So it was also just like really heavy. So wherever I was, I had to sort of carry it around. And it was always, you know, there was no one that could help me because no one could be in the room so that I could have the freedom at any point, you know, to move the laptop around. So there could be no sound, there was no one else there, which was really freeing. But also there's just like quite a lot of pressure to get it right.
I would say freeing, but also as an actor, a little bit difficult because, you know, you do, part of your job is to be, you know, interacting with someone. So it must have been a little harder to sort of tap into that. Yeah.
Well, I think because it was because I had to really focus and concentrate, it actually made me feel more free to respond to Shahzad, because it felt like Amy was getting ready to talk to Bilal every time I was about to do a take, because I had to make sure that I knew everything that I was doing. And I knew, you know, whereas Shahzad didn't have to do anything of like that. He just had to just sit in front of the camera because not, you know, his screen wasn't being recorded.
Right.
So he could have,
No,
he could do whatever he wanted, you know.
I was going to say, by the way, I would have fallen for Shahzad in a millisecond.
I mean, I was convinced I was in love with him during filming. I was like, well, I'm in love with him. That's it. I've fallen in love with him. And then obviously, as soon as the movie finished, we were like, okay, it's definitely not love. But I love him so much. He's become such a dear friend. But yeah, I think because we were improvising so much, I definitely like, you know, I became Amy for sure.
Yeah. Well, talk about that being, you know, kind of research that you did to be a journalist, especially in these times, you know, and dealing with all the technology and whatnot, but also just, you know, this woman's, you know, I think still at her core, even though she was kind of getting sucked in, at her core, she wanted to expose the story. So can you talk a little bit about, you know, the journalistic part of it?
Yeah, I think that was one of the things in my early days of research that I really wanted to make sure that I got right. So I, you know, spent time with journalists, with freelance journalists, when they would go into their offices as well. I wanted to see like how a newsroom ran, you know. I wanted to be around that kind of hunger so that I could, I mean, I had a sense of it because as an actress, I'm very ambitious and we need to be quite dogged because there's so much competition. But I definitely wanted to make sure that she felt authentic, you know, and because of the citizen journalism that was going on at that time, you know, there was, you know, you could search something on Twitter and find out where it was happening and go straight there. You know, right. Your publication didn't need to send you somewhere. It was a very, you know, and that's how Anna found so much information out, is that, you know, she was able to track these stories using, you know, social media and stuff. I found it, like, it was interesting because there's so little structure to journalism, to journalist life now, you know, mm-hmm. There's so many avenues that you can go down to track a story. But I just wanted to make sure that you could see that she wasn't a silly scatterbrain, that she was like a ambitious, because that's who Anna was, you know, and that's how the book reads, as someone that is, you know, is absolutely determined to get her scoop.
Yeah. Well, you did a very good job with that. And of course, the subject matter is just terrifying. Yeah. I mean, I know I've heard of these, you know, I've heard of this, but it just to see it sort of play out is just how these young women got sucked in. I mean, what are your thoughts about that?
I think, you know, for me as well, when I took on the role, I was aware of it too, just from reading newspapers. And then obviously I didn't realize quite how prolific it was. And I think I had a much more sympathetic understanding of these women. I could understand it struck me as they're not just silly girls, you know, they're actually outsiders on the fringes of society who are desperate to fit in somewhere.
Right.
And I, you know, I hope that that's what the film depicts, is that, you know, Bilal is just as lonely as Amy is, you know, and they both find each other through this very sort of manipulative, murky, kind of messy situation. But it's about a polarized society, which we all, I mean, even more we are now because of the pandemic.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I don't know, but I suppose the need for real community, that we, how important community really is, because if you don't have community, you end up following, you know,
yeah,
country, you know.
It's true. And I guess you're right. It kind of does, even though this took place before the pandemic, as you know, as far as with the timeline, but you know, how people are sort of still searching for that kind of stuff. And so then you get wacky people who go down the rabbit hole, you know, and it's just, yeah. It's a scary thing.
Yeah, it really is. It is. So I mean, I hope that the film outlines that and makes people more aware of how, you know, how vigilant they need to be.
Mm. Yes. And if they're younger and they're on their computers, you know, parents have to be a little more, you know.
Yeah. But, also because how much you can hide stuff now.
Right.
There's like so many like undercover websites and like, you know, apps where you can never trace anything. And it's just, it is kind of crazy. It's like, you know, we can all be sort of spy kids just on our phone and no one can find anything. You know, it's mad.
It is. It is, you know, crazy.
I was just going to say with the advent of the dark web, how now you can like order anything that you want, which is just terrifying, you know?
It is.
Like when, you know, when someone said the dark web to me at the very beginning when I didn't know, I laughed and thought, yeah, the dark web. And I didn't realize it was a real thing, you know?
Yeah. And, you know, it's like, well, you know, sometimes you might be curious and you go, well, what is it? And you might type and then you think, God, if I do that, suddenly, I'll be like...
That's why I was so scared of the stuff that I was researching for the role. I was like, oh my God, my history, my cookies, my cache, it's going to be crazy. I don't know if there's someone looking at my computer now, you know?
It is. I know. It's a little scary. I mean, I love computers and I'm not afraid of them, but it's like, I definitely, you know, there is some fears to it, but we only have a few minutes left, but I wanted to ask about Timur, because is it Timur?
Timur.
I love him as a filmmaker too. And I read that you did as well. I just think he's fantastic. So just quickly talk about the fabulous Timur.
I just was so excited to work with an auteur. You know, as an actress, you're just always like, all you want is strong vision, you know, because sometimes we can be so, as actors, you need to be malleable. And you know, you want someone that really knows what they want. So although he was the most collaborative director I've ever worked with, you know, the fact that I flew to Moscow and sat in an editing suite with him and looked at what I did and said, I don't like that. Can we try it this way? And he'd go, yeah, sure, let's do that. Wow. Was just, I mean, it really has spoiled me, because obviously projects after that, I'm like, oh, you don't care about what I do. And it will be some editor that will decide whether this take is going to be in the film or not. It was just, he is just the most generous. And, you know, like he's really got his like finger and his eyes on the pulse. Like he really is so visionary when it comes to, I mean, the fact that, you know, and he's got so many more ideas up his sleeve for what Screen Life could be. It was just, yeah. I mean, we genuinely had a blast making this film.
Yeah.
There's only people like this.
I know. Well, maybe I don't know if they're listening. I can talk to Timur as well about this, but it was very lovely talking with you.
Thank you so much. So lovely talking to you too.
And congrats on this. And I'm definitely going to spread the word. So well done.
Thank you so much. Have a nice day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Are you falling in love with him?
It's all just part of the recruitment process.
Becca.
What's the training program like for converts like us?
Hey, baby.
What are you looking at?
Nothing, I'm looking at you.
You wouldn't lie to me, would you?
Baby, I bought the ticket, I'm coming.
This has gone far enough.
I'm reeling him in.
Who's there with you?
No, you say you're...
What?
My God, I'm staring at my screen.
He's a terrorist.
Oh my God.
You know who I am? We'll find you in a matter of minutes.
No, please don't.
Delete your account.
I need to make sure there's a connection so I know where he is, if he's behind my door.
Amy. What's going on?
I'm gonna treat you like a queen.